开看。18 grams, good. So when you're hitting the porta filter, see the coffee tip is here. If you want the tip to come to you, you hit it there. Then the tip will come to you. If you want coffee to go there, you hit there. If you want coffee to go here, you hit here. If you want coffee to go here, you hit here. Okay, so that's none. Normally we will do stock flat, but we're kind of rich. We're rich and lazy. And this normally produces a better result. Hand, human will always make stupid mistake. Machines, rarely. Machine will only break down. So my total extraction time is around 1 minute. Until first drip lah. So first drip around 20 seconds. So this is all important information because you know that when you activate the infusion, not extraction, this is infusion. So when you activate infusion, around 20, 22, 23 seconds. So when you activate this, you got 20 plus seconds to do what you want to do. Pick up lah, prepare this lah, not everything okay lah. No one needs help, okay. Back, push. I add a bit of cooler water, maybe half-half, so easier to taste. But for customer, it's all just pure hot water drenching. The worst thing you can do is like you put so much effort into your coffee, it's done already. Customer drink it,
not hot enough.
Always
with latte. You steam it to perfect 60, 62 and 63 degrees. Then oh, sweet latte. Oh, sweet coffee must be sweet, not hot enough. Have this hot enough, burn the finger. This is the type of flavor I want.
Smooth, yeah.
Sweet. Little bit acidity, little bit bitterness. This is the flavor I want. Okay? So, 这种咖啡你设计10个人啊，8个人没有问题的。 Because 它没有一个东西是很呛。 如果它一个很酸的话, Ethiopia, for example, Ethiopia 人家最容易出错的。 你 serve 给 Ethiopia 的酸的，因为 we all know Ethiopia 一定酸的嘛， Ethiopia 那里可能不酸的， yeah, that's why. So fruity will give you an impression of acid, yeah. Typical Ethiopia extraction 啊，will tend to under extract. Typical cafe running Ethiopia will tend to under extract in an attempt to get out fruity notes. Okay? But what they don't understand is if you under extract too much, no sweetness, you don't get fruity notes. Yeah. Okay, because a fruit is, it has acidity, it has sugar, acid and sugar. So acid and sugar, if you just bring out the acid, then no sugar, then it tastes like lemon lah. If your lemon juice, you add lots of sugar, then wow, my nice one. Yeah. That's sort of the concept behind extracting Ethiopia. Okay, so long black, pass. Okay, so we do one white. For white, my ratio is very different. So for this so far, my ratio is between 1 to 2. 1 gram of espresso to 2 grams liquid. between 1 to 2 and 1 to 2.25. That's my ratio normally. Espresso I will pull maybe a bit longer. So espresso I will pull a bit longer, maybe 38-39ish. Then for milk I will pull 1 to 1 to 1 to 1.15. So between 18 grams and 21 grams out. 18 in, 18 out, or up to 21 out. So this is to condense the flavor. 10 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Always forget about time. Okay, latte cup. Same thing, stay short. I got 20 seconds to do whatever I want. Take me, let's go to Tengan. Take here. Pour until what I want. Okay. I still got 10 seconds. Tengan here. Put it back. Come back here. Wet my cloth. And drain my cloth. Then slowly fold my cloth. Then put back here. Then fur. Okay. I can start the extract now. See, I can do so much shit within 20-25 seconds. And it's like doing it at a very very slow pace. Okay. So wait till extraction goes around. And let's try a super 1 to 1 . Okay. 18.5. Because normally people, what was your latte ratio? Last time when you made espresso or when you made coffee, what was the grammage of your espresso that you pull out? Is it 30 something or 1 to 1 or what's the ratio?
Depending, every day it's different, yeah.
Normally,
so it's 18 grams or 18.5 something grams. We normally eyeball.
Calibration sheet. and that's done. No? Normally calibration doesn't take 1.5 hours, no? It's just that I have to take you through the theory. Normally calibration in the morning, it should take around 15 minutes. If you are really fast, 10 minutes can be done. Okay, so just now you noticed that I did a change here.
Yeah.
And I basically, I did a change without testing whether or not the change went in my favor. I straight away do, and I know it will turn out to be this flavor. Okay, remain my temperature. How much to pre-infuse I already have in my brain. Do a shot, make the coffee out. So this is what I want from you guys. Every morning, you must use brain on. Don't use your brain, you forever finding the grind size. Yeah. And find grind size one time, purge one time, then one shot gone. Then, not the flavor I want. Change again, purge again, throw again, change again, purge again, throw again. It's like literally throwing away money. This is like literally this purging and this throwing away is throwing away money. It's like 3 ringgit every time you do this. Because we're doing specialty. Specialty is expensive. If you don't have enough skill behind your baristas to understand the cost of specialty bean, to use without waste the specialty coffee bean, literally all the money we earn go into this, we take to the trash end of the day. Okay? So that's all for today. Hope you enjoyed that chemistry lesson. It's gonna be a long series of videos, so we will be up to date as more people come in, as we develop our training more and more. This is a very preliminary kind of training that we do for baristas here. But as they get better, we introduce more stuff, more factors to change, more variables, more intense lesson, and generally just like more stuff and toys to play around with in terms of coffee extraction. So yeah, that's it.